All right, this is our 3:45 press conference with South Dakota State head coach Aaron Johnston. Congratulations for making it into the Sweet 16 this year, and we'll have you start with your opening statement, please.
Well, appreciate it. It's been a whirlwind couple of days from one side of the country to the other, with a quick laundry stop, I think, for most of us to get regrouped. But we're really, you know, pleased, excited, fortunate, all those good words to be here. Played really well out in New York against two very good teams, and I thought our senior group in particular was outstanding and did a good job of helping us through some tough games. It's been a really good year for us. We're really proud of what we've accomplished and excited to be here and try and keep things going.
Hey, Aaron. Ryan Thorburn with the Register Guard. Just curious, it's kind of a coincidence that Kelly scheduled a trip to your place and then you happen to face him here. Obviously, you knew they were pretty good when they came to town, but what's it been like, I guess, coming out here and having to face them again in the Sweet 16?
Yeah, you know, it's certainly a neutral site, but they're going to have a pretty heavy Oregon Duck population here. We come back to Oregon next year to play, and so, three times in less than 12 months against the Ducks, that's a tall task for us. I've known Kelly for a while, played him when he was at Gonzaga and at we were at South Dakota State. Always does great things, and this team that they've got right now is just on a really, really, you know, good path, and certainly one of the elite teams in the country, not just in this region, but one of the elite teams in the country. So it's fun to have him in Brookings. We played well in that game, not quite well enough. Their offensive firepower was just a little bit too much for us in that game, so we'll have to find ways to slow them down and defend a little bit better. But it was a great experience for us. You know, playing teams like that throughout the last several years has, I think, really helped us get to this point and feel like we at least can put some things together to have a good plan going into this.
Travis Fossin from Kello TV in Sioux Falls. Coach, not that you needed a confidence boost, but those two games in Syracuse, what did it do for your team and your program just going into this round of 16? Did you see a little extra pep in the players?
Well, I think so. You know, we've been to the tournament a lot, you know, so obviously first time into this part of the tournament, but we've been to the tournament a lot. So I felt like the team was really comfortable going out there, knew what to expect, kind of have an idea of all the extras that go into it. I think the difference in that, you know, first, second round, both of those games compared to some of our previous times in the tournament, we just made plays at really critical times. You know, last year we lose an overtime game to Villanova and could have gone either way with a couple of baskets or a couple of stops. I thought the Quinnipiac game, you know, we had it under control. They made a run, but we made just a couple of plays there late to pull away. Syracuse, that game was back and forth. You know, they had us down double digits in the first half, in the second quarter. And then we had a good lead going in the fourth, and right away, you know, they got control again, but we made a good push at the end. And so I think the difference between this year and past years, we're just making plays at the right time. And a lot of that goes to, I think, our seniors as a group. You know, Sid Palmer, obviously Macy and Maddie have, you know, huge roles that they play, and they were a big part of both of those games. And so comparing, you know, where we are now to past years, just that confidence to make those big shots and big moments. And I think that's really what, you know, tournament games come down to. And it was fun to see our team respond really well in those games.
Ken Gill with the Oregonian. You mentioned cross-country trip, laundry stop here. They've only had to drive 100 miles up the road to get here. So can you talk a little bit about the disadvantage that your travel schedule maybe is to set you up for? And then they're talking about a crowd of 11,000 to 12,000. How do you feel about that? And, you know, how do you think your players will respond to that kind of atmosphere?
Yeah. Well, as far as them playing close to home, I mean, they've earned the right to do that. That's a great thing. Every program, the way our tournament is set up, you know, aspires to be able to do that. So, you know, we have no problems with that at all. That's how it is for every team in the tournament. And they've had the kind of year that gives them that right or that chance. So I think that's a great thing. As far as the crowd for tomorrow, you know, we're excited about that. It'll be a big crowd. We play in front of a lot of big crowds, nothing quite that large, but actually quite a few big crowds. You know, I know people in this area would follow that Oregon-Oregon State rivalry pretty closely, and that's a heated thing. We have some of those rivalries back home where it matters, where women's basketball really matters on that stage and on that day, and people follow those things closely and passionately. And we feel like we'll be on the other side of that in that game. So that's a good thing, though, too. You know, we want to be in an event where it is followed. You know, you don't want to get to this point and play in a half-filled, you know, arena. So we're excited about that. I think that'll be a good thing for both teams.
Taylor Budge, KSFY and Sioux Falls coach, you kind of touched on it a little bit earlier, but a lot has changed since December 12th when you last met them. How has your team grown since then?
Yeah, you know, you go back and watch that film, and after 4 or 5 minutes of watching, I thought, well, we're not even the same team. And then after watching them, I thought, oh, they're not the same team either. They're better than what they were on that day. And so both teams, I think, have really grown and kind of figured out how they're going to play in tough moments, how they're going to try and stop certain offenses, defenses. So I think both teams have really changed and grown. The key players are still the key players, and you have to try and control them and slow them down, and they'll have to do that with us. For us in particular, you know, Maddie and Macy were both very good in that game. People would expect that. Since then, you know, I think Maya Selland has really grown a lot as a player. Tylee Irwin has really grown an awful lot as a player, and so has Tagyn Larson. Those other three starters for us, watching them back in November and December compared to where they are now in March, just a huge difference in their confidence level. Peyton Burkhart, you know, was a freshman then and just trying to figure things out, playing against a top team in the country. Now she looks a lot more comfortable and settled. So I'd say the biggest thing for us has been how players have developed since then, particularly that group outside of our senior class. I think they've really come a long way, and they're a big part of why we've gone this far.
Travis Fawson from Kello TV again. Coach, can you expand a little bit with Peyton? She's 9 of 10 from the field in two games as a freshman in the NCAA tournament. She's been more than impressive.
Yeah, you know, she has been in a ton of big games in high school. And I know it's a whole different stage in this, so I'm not comparing it, but she's used to pressure. She's used to expectations. She just seems to play with such poise and calmness. You mentioned her field goal percentage. She made shots. She doesn't take shots she's not supposed to or tough ones. You know, she takes the ones that are great shots, and she makes them. But she also had some really good passes in both of those games, key passes. One of the threes that Maddie hit in that Syracuse game came from Peyton against their zone, and it was a tough angle, tough pass, and just really calmly put it right on the money, and Maddie obviously made the three. She's defending a position where I think sometimes she's a little bit undersized. She plays a five for us, but she's rebounding really well, and I think handling that part of it. So her composure has been, you know, exceptional, and if you get to know Peyton, you would expect that because she's just such a level-headed, calm, comfortable person away from basketball. I think that really translates on the court. So, yeah, she played as well as anybody in those minutes she gave us in New York. It was a big part of why we got it done.
Coach, Jeff Metcalf, Arizona Republic. I just wonder, did you try to recruit Kiana Ibis, and what do you remember about her at all from when she was living in South Dakota?
Yeah, we did. You know, and she would have been, you know, moved down to Nebraska when she really got kind of into it and going. She's a really good player. We absolutely did. We would have loved to see her in yellow and blue, but she's had a great career at Arizona State. She's a big part of what makes that team go. Her versatility is exceptional. She can be inside, outside. That left hand is tough for people to sit on. We were really aware of her and family ties to South Dakota for sure. Yep.
Other questions? All right, hearing none. Coach, thank you very much.
All right,
good luck tomorrow against Oregon. And player availability for South Dakota State will be at 4:05. I think I got him. So Guebert was the only one I had. Guebert. Yeah.
Tagyn.
right, once again, a couple quick reminders before we start the press conference. Again, please make sure your cell phones are on silent if you haven't done so already. No flash photography, no videography during the press conference. If you want the feed to be able to use, we can provide you the FTP link afterwards. We'll bring the microphone around to you for questions. Please say your name and affiliation before you ask your question, and we're asking you that each time you ask a question for our transcribers. If you want to address a question to all three student-athletes, please identify the first student-athlete that you want to answer that question, and then we'll pass along as after the question is answered by the first student-athlete. Student-athletes from South Dakota State, to my left, Madison Guebert, Tagyn Larson, and Macy Miller. And welcome. Congratulations on making the regional final round, and we'll go ahead and open it up for questions. Turn back.
Ryan Thorburn with the Register Guard. I'll address this to Macy. Since you guys already played Oregon and your coach was saying the key is going to be have a better defensive effort, where does that start when scouting them? Is it with Sabrina Ionescu? Is it Ruthie Hebert inside, someone else? Where do you guys need to improve defensively?
Yeah, I'd just say just good team effort. I think back home, we were kind of more one-on-one, didn't have a good lot of help defense, and we seen good do a good side in the post, like help side, and I think this time we just got to rely on our system that we've worked on all year, and that's good help side defense, closing gaps, especially on Sabrina, but she also helps the whole team get going, so I'd say it's a whole team effort.
Maddie, I'll address this one to you. We just
name and affiliation.
Sorry. Taylor Budge, KSFY. In Sioux Falls. Maddie, just talked to your coach, and he had said one of the things that you guys have done improving-wise since then is you become more of a team. It's not necessarily just you guys that are, you know, scoring the points. Do you kind of feel like the younger group on this team is starting to step up too?
Yeah, you know, we have a lot of confidence in all of our players, and we've had a lot of girls that have been stepping up, and it's not really just reliant on a couple of us scoring or two or three of us scoring, so we've really had a lot of, yeah, especially the younger players stepping up into bigger roles for us. And, you know, we've just been trying to instill that confidence in them to make those big shots because we know that they can. And, yeah, they've just been doing a really awesome job for us making those shots.
Travis Fossing from Kello TV in Sioux Falls for all three, maybe starting with Macy. It's been a whirlwind 48, 72 hours, and you've gone from the northeast to the northwest. Just talk about the last few days and how you've been able to refocus at this point.
Yeah, it's been a crazy few days, like you stated. You know, you come off that huge win, you're excited, and, you know, we fly in and we get back home at 2 in the morning, and we have people that go to classes, and then the next day we practice in the morning, got to get ready for Oregon, we watch film, and kind of got to refocus there, but you know, we get here, and, you know, it's just as exciting. You're in the Sweet 16, but you also have to focus because we don't want to settle here. We want to keep going, and we have a great team in front of us, and so we're looking forward to it.
Tagyn?
Yeah, I think we're all kind of running on excitement and adrenaline at this point, but we're just so excited to be here and staying focused and locked in on every practice, every shoot around. We're staying really focused, and so, yeah, it's been really good.
Madison?
Yeah, just trying to keep that momentum going from where we left off in Syracuse. And obviously, it's been a crazy, crazy few days for us between traveling back home and then traveling out here. But I think we're just using this excitement and energy kind of as momentum going forward. And, yeah, I think, you know, obviously it's very exciting to be here, but we're not done yet. And so, yeah, just trying to keep that focus as we go forward.
Zach Borg with KDLT. Macy, I'm sure you probably saw Mike playing some NBA gyms. What's it going to be like to play in one yourself now?
I think it's going to be something special. You know, I was getting super excited walking in here, just thinking LeBron James stepped walking through here, and I was pretty excited. But, you know, I'm excited to step out on the court and just be able to play in this arena. It's really cool that NBA teams play here. That's exciting.
Good.
Sort of to follow up on that, you guys get to the Sweet 16, but your award is to play Oregon. Have to play them in Portland, and they're talking about, you know, maybe 12,000 people here. Sort of maybe for Tagyn and the other players. What's your reaction to that, and how exciting or fearful is that?
Yeah, I think it's an exciting thing. There's going to be a lot of people there, even if they're for Portland. It'll bring a lot of energy into the arena. And I think we'll have a lot of Jockrabbit fans here, too. There was a lot of people on our plane, and a lot of parents flew out. And so I think the energy will be great in there.
Zach Borg with KDLT again. For all three of you, talk with some of the with the Oregon coach when they had their media availability. He said a couple of years ago when they first made the Sweet 16, it was all so new to them, but maybe that was an advantage because they just played more loose, play free. Do you think that'll be the case, especially for how much this has been built up as a moment for this program to get to now that you're here?
Yeah, like you said, it's the first time in the Sweet 16, but we don't want to settle here. And you know, we're ready for this game, and we just got to play like we have been all year. You know, obviously it's a big game, but, you know, it could be our last game as well. We just got to keep playing with that motivation we've had the whole year.
Taylor Budge with KSFI in Sioux Falls. Macy, is there any different approach than where you were a week ago playing two teams that you had never faced before compared to where you are now?
I wouldn't say it's much different, but like you stated, those games are a little bit different because you get like a day or two to focus on them, watch film on them, try to get, you know, what they're good at. But, you know, we faced this Oregon team before. We know what they're like, and obviously we've both gotten better since we last played them. And so it's going to be a really good game, but we just got to focus on the things that are our main focus.
Moderator question here. Both Coach Graves and Coach Johnston talked about how both teams, Oregon and South Dakota State, have improved and changed from that meeting in December to now. For all three of you, but we'll start with Madison. Talked about, in your eyes, what has changed in South Dakota State's approach and team play between December and now?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've improved a lot since December, and especially defensively, we're playing more together as a team. We're in help side a lot better. We're closing gaps a lot better, guarding the ball one-on-one a lot better. And then just we're playing a lot more aggressively, and I think offensively in the first time we played Oregon, we were pretty timid and passive, kind of getting into the basket. And so I think overall just we have a more aggressive mentality.
Tagyn?
Yeah, I think just going off what Maddie said, I think coming into this game, obviously both teams have improved a lot. So I think this time around, I think we're a lot more confident than what we were in December. And I think kind of what Maddie said, our defense has improved a lot, and I think that'll help a lot. And we just have confidence in ourselves and more confidence in each other.
Macy?
Adding on to that, like you said, everyone's doing a great job just stepping up into their role and just having their confidence. And I think since December, we've done a great job finding the open players and really knocking down the shots. You know, if a couple of people help, we're there to find the open person.
Yep, go ahead.
Zach Borg with KDLT. Madison, I know Drew's going to be here tomorrow. And actually, funny note that Sabrina Ionescu has a twin brother as well. What's that relationship meant to you? And how do you think he's going to react? Because obviously he didn't get a chance to play in the D2 tournament, much less the D1.
Yeah, I think he's excited for me, and it's kind of been crazy for him winding down his collegiate career. But, yeah, I've been in touch with him a little bit, but he's really excited to get out here, especially because he wasn't able to go to Syracuse. So, our relationship has meant the world to me, especially since college. We've gotten so close, and not that we weren't before, but I think being twins, we were never really apart from each other until we got to college. And so we truly are each other's biggest fans and number one supporters. And so to have him here for the Sweet 16 and something that's just beyond special to me, and I'm so excited that he's coming.
Other questions? All right, ladies, thank you very much for your time. Good luck tomorrow against Oregon. Practice time availability for the media.